Hi everyone, it's Attorney Latrice Knight, and your presenter today for questions to ask divorce attorneys at the first meeting. I am excited to move forward, but I'm going to give people a little bit more time to join us, so I'm going to give one more minute before I start, and we'll get started soon. Okay, everyone, Attorney Latrice Knighton here, and I'm ready to begin our presentation today, all about questions to ask a divorce attorney at the first meeting. And I know you guys are considering divorce, and you're like, hey, what should I be asking of these attorneys that I'm talking to? And I'm here to give you some tips right now. Now, before we get started, there's one request that I have of you. I've already done it, and I want you to do it too. I want you to silence your cell phone, close down any computers or distractions, close your door, and give yourself this time to learn something new. Because I understand that if you're going through the divorce process, there's a lot of transitions that are going to happen soon. And I want to make sure that you're prepared to begin having a conversation with an attorney about moving forward. Why? Because you matter, and what happens to you matters, and making sure you choose the right divorce attorney is really going to impact the outcome of your case and how your case moves forward. Now, I want you to stay tuned to the very end because you're going to learn how to get more free information. There's other webinars that we do here at Stern Law Offices, as well as seminars. And you know, you're scheduling a one-on-one with an attorney. We talk about that all at the end. So stay tuned, guys. Now, prior to coming to meet with an attorney for the first time, there is a lot of anxiety because you're not certain, and I'm sure many of you have seen television shows with or about attorneys, and either you have a positive or negative association to what we're like. One question that I have, especially in divorce, that a lot of people ask me is, are you tough enough? Like, are you going to, you know, be a pit bull or a shark in the courtroom? Are you going to be strong enough to handle my case? Will you be able to get me what I need and what I am entitled to? Because no one wants to hire an attorney who's not going to help them navigate everything. How much is it going to cost me? Are you going to take all the money based on the legal fees that you charge me? You know, based on all the experience I have, the thousands of cases I've been a part of, I can tell you right now, your experience with your attorney is all going to be based on, a lot of it's going to be based on communication. And we're going to talk to you in coming up about that, about how to determine if you and your attorney are going to be good communicators and what your style of communication is like and what your attorney's style is, etc. You know, today you're in the right place and joining us on this webinar if you want to make certain that you know what an experienced attorney looks like, what you should be finding and looking for in an attorney to represent you in your divorce. Because if this is the first time you've ever hired an attorney, that can be very scary. This is a very personal endeavor that you're going through, and you want to make sure that it's right. You're also in the right place if you want to find an attorney who's going to listen to you and listen to about what happened in the past with in your family with your spouse, about what your concerns are moving forward and what you really need. Because in the end, you really want an attorney who's going to fight for you. So you're in the right place if you're looking for an attorney who's going to advocate for you and your kids' best interests now and getting a result that's going to make your future even more bright. Here at Stern Law Offices, we're all about helping families move forward. with divorce, and so we focus 100% on family law. We don't do anything else. We don't do family injury law plus personal injury law, because a lot of the practices, they are apples and oranges to family law. We're here to help you and your family with all the decisions they have moving forward. And, you know, we have lots of experience here. We have over 100 years of experience. And through that experience, we've won awards. We're active participants in all these different organizations. We appear in front of judges all the time. We use all different types of experts and can guide our clients into the right experts that they need to be using for their divorce case. Because we really care about what our client's experience is through the divorce and making sure that we fight for them and their interests are heard, because this really impacts your long-term happiness. On our website, it's all over it, to be honest with you. We proudly display all our reviews, and we got a 4.4 out of 5 right now. And that's out of 558 reviews. So you can look on our website and see all the reviews and read from real clients. And I guess, clearly, we don't have all perfect scores. It's the real deal on what you're reading on the internet. Our strategy is to talk with you and get the best outcome for you. So that's what we're here to do, is to meet with you and help you get started. Now, the truth about divorce attorneys. Now you're going to see a whole bunch of attorneys from our office. This is Katie. She's one of our attorneys here, and has been doing divorce and been in the divorce field for a long time. We can talk. You'll meet with her. And this is Holly Mullins. I would like to say that the most experienced divorce attorneys only handle divorce cases all day and every day. I mean, you want an attorney who spends their time handling this work. Why? Because laws change. Court commissioners, judges' moves change. Experts, you know, if you use them enough, some are better in court than others. And so you want people who do this all day, every day, because they can give you the advice and the practical advice of what they're seeing in the courts each week. You want timely stuff. A good divorce attorney can give you different options on how you end your marriage. This is attorney Tricia Festerling. She's one of the partners here too, like Holly and her firm. And she does collaborative divorce, she does mediation, she's also a trial attorney. So you want people who can give you options on the way that you want to end your marriage. On our website and through a strategy session, we would talk you through which way that your divorce would actually end up. You want a divorce attorney who's responsive to you and communicates to you what's going on in your case and the next steps moving forward. This is partner Dan Exner. You know, he really prides himself, and you can see, I think a couple slides prior to, there was a positive quote about their experience with Dan. I mean, he really prides himself on communicating with his clients. And you also want a divorce attorney who will explain all your options to you, what will happen to you if you don't resolve this case prior to trial, and what they think the likely outcome will be at trial. And then you make the choice. Do you want to reach a settlement, or do you want to keep moving forward to trial? We can always help you with that. So in order to understand what attorney is going to be the right fit for you, you need to ask the best questions. And we're going to get started with you right now on the best questions to ask a divorce attorney at the first meeting. First question you want to ask is, how do you bill? I mean, do you bill by the hour, or is it a fixed fee? And those are the typical two ways that a divorce attorney is going to bill you. Hourly billing, your attorney bills for each hour they spend on your case, but really it's minute by minute. I mean, if you're doing an hourly, you'll see on your bill a breakdown of a telephone conference was 10 minutes and they're charging you $400 an hour. So that's a $40 telephone call. Typically then, if you're beginning billed hourly, that attorney is going to ask you to put down what's called a retainer, which is really just a large lump sum. And so after they go through that first $4,000 or $5,000 they ask of you, and you don't really know how it's going to be broken down, it's just you get a bill and it shows all the work that's been done in your case and then increments of time that were spent on it. And then at the end, they'll say how much you have left over in your account. And after that $4,000 or $5,000 is spent, then they're going to ask for another $4,000 or $5,000. And they're not really giving you estimates on how much it's going to cost. You just keep putting down money. Some people are uncomfortable with that because they're going through the divorce process and want a budget, really. They want to know what the real outcome and cost is going to be from for each stage of the divorce. And so that's really what a fixed fee is. You pay per stage, or you pay for the amount of work that's going to be done, and you know what it is, and you budget for it. And, so you need to determine, you know, when you're reaching out to law firms, which fee they use, or billing system, either fixed fee or do they bill hourly. The second question you want to ask is an attorney is, what do they think the timeline is going to be from start to finish? Because I know that's the burning question on your mind, is how long is this thing going to take? Because I want to move forward. So, you know, how long will it take that attorney to file your divorce and get an initial hearing and start requesting information from your spouse or the other attorney? And when are you going to start talking about the kids and sending over an offer to resolve all this stuff? And if I have to go to trial or not, what's that going to look like? How long is that going to take? You know, I've practiced long enough that I've had people who had previous attorneys who wanted to move the case because their attorney was a little bit of a slow mover. If you're not, for instance, on a fixed fee where you're based on stages, I mean, sometimes your case can drag on and you just got to keep paying that retainer. Third question, what is the likelihood that I'm going to win? Is another question that people want to know and ask and are thinking about in the back of their mind. Divorce is not really a winner-take-all type of thing, but your attorney should be able to explain the likelihood of you getting child support, alimony, or certain property division, or what a custody and placement schedule is going to look like, just based on the facts that they hear. I mean, if they've been practicing family law long enough, they're going to be able to tell you what your county judges and court commissioners are doing and how a guardian might view your case. Now, if an attorney makes a promise that they can get you something, normally attorneys talk in ranges, like, you know, here's what I've seen, or here's what the statutes say or case law says. But if they're making, like, guarantees, it's too good to be true. And if they are making you guarantees, tell them to put it in writing, because, you know, we have to do it based on the facts that we learn about. So sometimes you don't even know that there's something else out there because your spouse is hiding something from you. So we got to learn about your entire case before we can give you all of it, but we can give you a pretty good idea of what it's going to look like. You know, sometimes you will be promised some huge amount of money. I think I've heard some attorneys will say, oh, I know you can guarantee you're going to get X, Y, and Z. Well, again, have them put it in writing because there's really no guarantees. It's either you're going to reach a settlement or you're going to do a trial, but we can give you very good educated guesses on what's going to happen, and we can tell you when you need to push more, because sometimes you don't even know what you're entitled to. So an attorney can really help you push for the things that you're entitled. Another question, you need to be asking an attorney you meet with, what professionals do you think I'm going to need to hire in order to get the best outcome? Because sometimes it's hiring experts to value property or retirement accounts or businesses or determine earning potential or see if a spouse wasted money on, you know, an addiction or something. You need to know, again, what all different types of experts there are that could be possible in your case. I mean, I went over a large group of them, but trust me, there's a lot more that we work with all the time here at Stone Law Offices. So just because I didn't bring it up doesn't mean that person doesn't exist. I'm just trying to give you a general overview. And there are some fees associated with it. So if you're going to have to use an expert, you should also ask what fee. And again, that goes into this next question of how much is it all going to cost me? Because, you know, you want to know what this real budget is going to look like. You want to understand the cost of just filing the case and going to a trial. Or if you start the case and you end up negotiating on a deal, what's that going to look like as far as cost? Because, you know, it's cheaper to negotiate a deal than ever to a trial, because because by the time you've gotten to a trial, your attorney has done a lot of work, and probably, we're not talking about that here in this webinar, but I do in a different one, about discovery and what that all entails, and there's a lot of cost involved with that. So it's cheaper, clearly, to negotiate a deal than go to trial. So you need to ask the attorney, what's that cost going to be between the two? You also should ask an attorney, what if you and your spouse can actually sit in a room together and come up with an agreement, if your case would be good for mediation. Mediation is when the two of you hire one mediator, who's an attorney, to talk you through dividing up all your assets, debts, liabilities, and coming up with the custody and placement schedule. It gives you certainty of knowing what the outcome is going to be than to leaving it up to a judge and a court system in their calendar. You guys create the calendar, you guys talk through it, you guys get the information, and you get divorced much quicker. Sometimes the two of you can, or one of you wants to just hire an attorney for an hour of time just to look at forms. We do offer some limited coaching here. But sometimes it's like, we've done everything. We came up with a parenting plan. We divide all the assets, but hey, I don't want to get this wrong. I just want you to look it over to make sure this says what I think it says. We do offer that service here too. So it is important to know there are different types of services, from coaching to mediation to just traditional legal representation. Ask the attorney the different prices of those, if those are the things that you're considering, and they should be able to give it to you. So again, the five questions to ask a divorce attorney. Do you bill hourly or offer fixed fee? What will the timeline be from start to finish? What is the likelihood that I will win? What professionals do you think I'll have to hire? And how much is this going to cost? You may have more questions, and if you do, that's totally normal and totally fine. Why don't you give us a call here at Sterling Law Offices to schedule a strategy session where you can then talk about you, your family, and ask all the like individualized questions that you have. And you can learn how to schedule one of those sessions by going to sterlinglawyers.com. I will see you next time on another webinar, in person at a seminar, or maybe I'll see you in the office just for a strategy session. Until then, guys, you guys have a great day, and I hope to talk to you soon. Bye-bye.